David Deida, the way of the superior man. Do you understand what it means to be a man? Do you understand the differences between masculinity and femininity? Do you understand polarization and how polarization affects attractiveness? Do you understand life purpose and how you can maintain beautiful relationships with women? If any of these points interest you, then this book is something I'd very highly recommend. David Deida is a spiritual guru, so to speak, and he's put together this book which contains 51 life lessons for men and how to create a superior man and a superior life. So I read this book, and bear in mind, I'm not a very spiritual person. So when I was reading this book, I did notice that there were passages and texts which did seem slightly out there to me because I haven't really been exposed to spirituality yet. However, I do think David Deida really hits some key points, and it opened my eyes to a few aspects that I hadn't really realized before. Let me just go through four of the key points that I picked up during this book, and maybe this will open your eyes too. The first point that I thought was very interesting, probably the most pressing point that he makes during the book, is that as a man, you need to have a life purpose. And he actually gives an analogy of what a life purpose is. He says it's like an onion, and that you can peel back the layers on your onion and just keep working away at your life purpose over time. It's not that you actually know what the core looks like yet, but you do know the steps. You can see the steps and you go in the right direction until you get to the core. What he says about life purpose is that you should ground your woman with your life purpose. So he describes women as being highly emotional beings, and he says the man's job is to stay true to his life purpose and not be swayed by the whims and demands of his woman. I thought that was an interesting way of putting it, and I can see that the concept of neediness, which is also discussed through the book, is heavily related to this concept of staying true to your life purpose and not be swayed. The second thing that I thought was interesting in this book is this concept of polarization. So David Deida talks about how masculine men and feminine females attract each other. There's a scale of masculinity and femininity, and for maximum attractiveness, the man and the woman should be at either ends of the spectrum. Of course, you do get some feminine men and you do get some masculine women, so David Deida talks about this, but ultimately, to create attractiveness, a man needs to make sure he's a polar opposite to that of his woman. He needs to be aware of this at all times, and he can't sway to the other end of the spectrum and expect the attractiveness to remain. I thought that was an interesting way of putting it. The third thing that I thought was interesting is David Deida's thoughts on promiscuity. He says, as a man, you will always want to see and have sex with other women. You can't remove these desires as part of being a man. And he talks about the difference between suppression and discipline. And he says that discipline is pertaining to your higher value, and suppression is just trying to suppress your desires. Suppression doesn't work, but self-discipline does. Overall, I'd say this book is a very good read, especially if you are having trouble maintaining a long relationship with women. If you're having trouble attracting women and you don't really understand what it means to keep a good long-term relationship alive and active, this is a great read for you. If you don't have any purpose in life, if you're just swaying and you're not really sure which direction you're going, and you're not really sure what it means to be a man, this book is a great read for you. If you're not a spiritual person like myself, you'll still pick up many important ideas. Just the way they're described might be a little bit out there for you. Overall, if you've read this book, leave a comment below. Let me hear what your thoughts on it are. This video that you're watching right now is all part of my self-development experiment, where I try and read 140 books in as short a time as possible. I've produced video reviews of those books, and my ultimate goal is to improve my reading retention, and my video presentation. If you want to learn more about this experiment and anything else I'm doing, click on the link below, and I hope to hear from you soon. Thank you very much.